Alambana, Wikipedia article audio. Vedanta. Alambana is a Sanskrit noun which variously means support, foundation, supporting, base, sustaining, cause, reason, basis, or the five attributes of things, or the silent repetition of a prayer, or the natural and necessary connection of a sensation with the cause which excites it, or the mental exercise practiced by the yogis in endeavoring to realize the gross form of the eternal. Vedic implication. Rasa implication. In Indian philosophy, the word Alambana refers to the objective basis of a perception or sensation, according to which philosophy karana and all attendant emotional conditions are known as vibhavas, which are of two kinds: a alambana, the personal and human object and substratum, and b udapana, the excitant. Alambana may further be divided into asraya and visaya. Radha is asraya and Krishna is visaya. Radha, as the devotee, experienced greater pleasure than Krishna, who remained the object of her veneration. Visaya is the potential object of a perceptual consciousness. Alambana is the objective basis, which can even be the cause of perceptual or cognition support for a perceptual error. The Naya school does not consider the object in front to be the alambana of the illusory cognition, but rather the interfering external element with its own characteristics. The best alambana for the upasana of Brahman is Om. In Vedic parlance, alambana is also known as skamha, i.e. the pillar of strength. God is the pillar of strength. It is the objective contemplation which lends support to the mind in its travel Godwards. In the Indian theory of rasa, udapana is the excitant or determinant which inflames sentiments or emotions, and alambana is that on which the sentiment hangs, i.e. alambana is with reference to the sentiment which arises as the link between a sentiment and the cause which excites it. In rasa process, the nature or object is said to be visibly present before the asraya as an excitant, but the object that arouses emotions is usually imagined by the poet or dramatist. The mere presence of vibhava impels the configuration of pratibha to change it in no time. As per the rasa of heroic devotion in compassion, the enhancing excitants include transitory emotions such as impatience, understanding, and happiness, and Krishna in some disguised form is offered by the hero, motivated by kindness, his own body. Yudhisthira had made sacrificial offerings to Krishna. With the aid of self-supported yoga or Atmambana yoga, Ishvara can be seen in two ways, i.e. dual and non-dual, or can be seen as fourfold. Alambana refers to inner support and yoga refers to self-discipline. Atmalambana yoga is the discipline of objectifying the non-self with the aid of the self when the negated self becomes the object of the self. Patanjali, while defining sleep, which is a vritti of buddhi, just as the waking state and the dream states are, tells us. Yogic implication. Here, he has used the word alambana to mean support or based on, i.e. absence of impressions is supported / based on inertia. According to the Yogacara phenomenology, the alambana condition, whether immediate, direct or remote, means if there exists a dharma it will have a distinct appearance. The mind will sometimes correspond with it for that dharma to be cognized and perceptually grasped. This condition leads to the awakening, which results in the ending of the eight consciousnesses and replacing them with four enlightened cognitive abilities. The Buddhists consider alambana as a cause same as hechu, samanantara, and adhapadi. They consider it to be the object condition which is taken as the cause in the production of knowledge and mentals, such as siddha and kaya. According to Nagarjuna, there are three motivational contexts of love and compassion, viz., sattva lambana, motivated by the similarity of oneself with other selves, dharmalambana, motivated by the sameness of psychophysical elements, and analambana, which is not motivated by these two, i.e. which is independent of motivational context. Xuanzang, in the context of Dignaga's statement with reference to the eighth consciousness, explains that the seeds or virtualities of the eighth consciousness produce the actual consciousness and also the objective base of actual consciousness. Buddhist implication. Advaita, Vishishtadvaita, Dvaita Vedanta, Vedabheda, Dvaitadvaita, Akintya Beta Abhita, Shuddhadvaita.